chances are you're going to be using a stable coin in the near future. I'm going to be talking about Tether. There's some really interesting developments happening, and I think you're going to want to hear about it. But first, I want to go over a friend that wrote me today. He's also part of the learningcrypto.com member. And he said, "You've helped me a lot. I've never been wealthy until now. It's sure freeing to think about what lies ahead financially. I own Bitcoin because of you." So my encouragement to everyone here is that regardless of where you are financially, there's always hope for you. So my encouragement is that you can all find financial success. And this is how we did it, by buying Bitcoin earlier on and having patience, because I think later on, you're still going to be fine if you're buying Bitcoin right now. All right, let's get it right into this. So 11 years ago, Bitcoin reached $100 for the first time. And I remember that day going, I was in this, a three-bedroom apartment or two-bedroom apartment with like five guys living there. And we were all just like trying to save money. I was putting everything I had into Bitcoin at that time. I was working Uber, and I just remember waking up one day and it was $100. I couldn't believe it. And I'm like, wow, this is crazy. How much higher could it go? $200? I had no idea where we'd be at right now. I just knew that it was the most brilliant thing I've ever read, which was the Bitcoin white paper, because I like permissionless systems, guys. All right, moving on. We have breaking, Bitcoin records highest monthly close ever in history. So over $70,000, that's pretty impressive considering just 11 years ago, we were at $100. All right. Next, we have the Turkish lira. If you've ever been to Turkey, we've been to Turkey. Last time we were there, the Turkish lira was around like 3 or 4 Turkish lira to the US dollar. Today, it hit 32.4 to the US dollar. This is hyperinflation, guys. This is why you need Bitcoin, because the average currency, I think it's around 28 years old. The US dollars are just over 50 years old right now, because after 1971, Nixon took the US off the gold standard, which created a brand new currency based on debt, not on gold. All right, let's move on to Tether. So this is from Thomas Hey Apollo, great guy to follow on Twitter. And if you want to follow me, at Sir Crypto Tips, I'm very vocal. That's an understatement. All right, end of Q1. Tether purchased 8,888 Bitcoin. This brings their total treasury to 75,354 Bitcoin. And this is consistent with Tether's treasury reserve strategy of saving 15% profits in Bitcoin. I think that's really smart. Now, Tether has become the seventh largest Bitcoin holder in the world. And I think they have $5.2 billion. Now, you might want to ask, why are they being so upfront now? Here's why they are being so transparent. Tether has announced, this is from Cointelegraph, Tether has announced the successful completion of a system and organization controls to SOC audit, the highest level security compliance that an organization can demonstrate. The audit was developed by the American Institute of Certified Accountants. The audit underscores Tether's commitment to offering a secure user experience, according to the CEO of Tether. So why are they doing this? Well, keep in mind that Circle, their competitor, who manages USDC, is now owned pretty much by BlackRock. Anything Coinbase related or whatever is owned by BlackRock now. So Tether has the majority market share of stablecoins, and they want to keep it that way, and they don't want to give it to BlackRock. So this is their way of being more transparent and more, you know, upfront of what they are doing. And I think it could work, because, man, Tether's been being attacked for years and years and years. I remember like two bull markets ago, like it's so much FUD on Tether. And they kept themselves together. And there was, I mean, nonstop FUD. So later on in the bull market, when prices go crazy, you're probably going to want to take your coins out into, or some of your alts. I would definitely get out all the alts into a stable coin. And you're going to have to make that choice probably earlier on, which is going to be better off for you. Because, you know, at the time when prices are going crazy, you don't want to have to decide which stable coin you're going to be in. I would suggest that you figure that out right now. And this is a kind of an interesting thing that's happening. And maybe Tether's going to want to compete with BlackRock. I don't think they're going to win. I think BlackRock's going to dominate. But regardless, it's really interesting. And, you know, when I first started this space, there was no such thing as a stable coin. I think stable coins came around, at least I first heard about them around like 2016, 2017. But I think they've been around since 2014. But I just wasn't comfortable with using them at that point. Time and you probably would understand why. Anyways, what are your thoughts? Please tell me down below, what are your thoughts? What stable coin do you like more? And also, if you do want to check us out at learningcrypto.com, and that is where you get our Sierra trade alerts, portfolio updates, and you get to see when we take profits and what stable coins we are going to be getting into when we do take profits. Anyways, that's all I have. Please like and subscribe, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye.